everyone. My greetings reach out to all of you, and I hope and pray that you all are doing well. The times that we are living in today are difficult, different, unsure, perturbing, and highly exasperating for all of us. We at Presentation Convent Jammu are doing our best to educate one and all regarding the COVID-19 pandemic. And the alumni of our school, who are doctors, are working across the globe as harbingers of life, keeping the flame of selflessness alive.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Varsha Bald. I've had the proud privilege of doing my schooling from Presentation Convent School, Jammu, and I passed from this prestigious institution in the year 2004. I'm highly indebted to my alma mater and all my wonderful teachers for helping me shape into what I am today. And I'm really privileged and honored to have been given this opportunity by my school to address you all.
Hi, I'm Dr. Saima Sadiq. I'm a gynecologist. I'm working as an assistant professor at GMC Kathua.
My name is Dr. Deshpandu Sharma. I was born in Jammu and went to Presentation Convent School. During my time in 1989 when I graduated, there were about 30 boys in the school and I was one of them.
Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Sonali Sharma. I'm a radiologist at Medanta, the Medicity, Gurgaon. I'm very thankful to my alma mater for giving me this opportunity to interact with you all.
Hi friends, students and teachers of my alma mater Presentation Convent School, Jammu. I passed out from the school in the year 1987 and then later on I did my further schooling 11th and 12th standard in Jammu and then came to Pune to do my medical college. After passing out from the medical college, I did my MBA in international business and joined a vaccine manufacturing company called Serum Institute of India. You must have heard of it.
Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Juhi Sharma. I would like to express my deepest gratitude to my alma mater, Presentation Convent High School, Jammu, from where I began the journey of my career.
I'm currently working as a consultant cardiologist in Batra Hospital, Delhi, which is a COVID-designated hospital. Coming to the COVID-19 pandemic, it's like the stuff shown in the science fiction movies, except for the fact that this time it's for real. It's like a nightmare beyond our wildest imagination, and we all are finding it very difficult to cope up with the current situation. But we have to understand that it's an infection that can involve any organ system in the body, including the heart.
I know these are very extraordinary, challenging, and uniquely difficult times for one and all. I know we are getting anxious, depressed, but I feel this is the right time to strengthen and sharpen all our weapons in this fight. And I feel that the greatest weapon that we have is our mental health and sanity.
Presently, I work in a specialized orthopedic and trauma hospital under the Ministry of Health, Kuwait. Now coming to the topic at hand, COVID-19. Why is this novel coronavirus so dangerous as compared to SARS or MERS? This has a myriad of reasons. But first and foremost, it's extremely contagious. We all know that. Secondly, there's a long asymptomatic period during which the patients are still infected. This is the time when actually it's hardest to detect the individuals and therefore it leads to a rampant spread of the virus. This is what has resulted in a pandemic. Society too plays a huge role as many people are hesitant or outrightly scared to admit that they are infected and often try to disguise the fact that they are COVID-19 positive.
Now, during this COVID-19, which everybody is suffering throughout the world, we have a lot of patients who are dying because of this. I live currently in San Antonio and I have been into practice for the last 9 years. In this practice, I am coming across patients who have COVID-19, but from the GI standpoint, there are some symptoms that can present, or these patients can present with these GI symptoms other than just the pulmonary symptoms. And the symptoms are in the form of nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and diarrhea. Most of the patients, they ignore these symptoms, but if they ignore these symptoms, they develop serious complications of pulmonary symptoms in the form of cough, which is usually dry cough with shortness of breath and fever. But in San Antonio, we had till date more than 2,000 cases and around 60 patients have died because of this disease. For the GI standpoint or otherwise, in order to prevent this disease to spread, what we can really do is just to wash our hands. Again, take all precautions, and these are just the common sense things. Common sense in the sense of keeping distance, washing your hands, and making sure not to expose the sick ones, because most of the patients who are dying because of this disease are usually elderly patients and patients who have other illnesses, especially diabetic, hypertensive, and patients with heart failure.
I know all of us have been going through a very difficult and challenging time.
How to be sane in these very, very insane times? Just think of this period as that 2-month summer vacation that we used to have. Just utilize this time to rediscover the artist, the painter, the chef, the dancer, the singer, the yogi, the gymnast within yourselves. Do everything that you have been wanting to do since such a long time and you have not been finding time.
How to boost your immunity? First, exercise, very important. Second, a healthy diet, which consists of lots of fruits and vegetables, no junk food, eating only home-prepared food, consuming vitamin C, vitamin D and zinc, which play a pivotal role. And of course, a good night's sleep is very important. Most importantly, please do not forget to de-stress yourself. Please take measures to relieve yourself from stress by meditation or any other thing which calms you down. Because one of the factors which decreases immunity is even stress. This may be surprising, but it's actually true. Anxiety is expected in these circumstances, considering what we are going through. But then again, we all are in the same boat, and anxiety definitely is not the solution. Keep yourself calm and try to stay relaxed most of the time.
At Serum Institute, we are working on 5 different vaccine candidates. And the most popular amongst them is the ChAdOx1 vaccine. You must have heard about that vaccine, which is manufactured by Oxford University, the Jenner Institute in UK. And so we have partnered with them, and that vaccine is already into the final phases of the clinical trial. The results of this vaccine clinical trial will be available sometime in the month of September or October. And once those results are available and the product is successful, we come to know that the results are favorable, then we would be able to launch the vaccine worldwide.
I know this period, as all things shall be overcome with time. It may be stressful as of now, but I believe that we all will emerge victorious. Till then, we have to fight this war with a positive outlook. So in the end, stay calm, stay safe, stay home. Most importantly, stay positive. Thank you very much.
Till then, I would like to say that follow all precautions, and whatever they show on the TV or the Ministry of Health, whatever they say regarding the sanitization and social distancing and keeping the masks on, please follow all that stuff. And particularly the elderly people and the small children, because their immunity is low and they are more vulnerable to the infections, please stay at home until unless it is very, very important for you to go out. One should not venture outside.
If you have any questions, you can always reach me at my email address, which is deshvsharma@yahoo.com, or go to my website at www.stargastroenterology.com. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Friends, I feel that we shall overcome. So have Shraddha, have Saburi, stand tall, stand brave. We shall overcome.